Get in your chair. Okay. Who's a good boy? Who's a good boy? You're a good boy, Spud. You're a good boy. Yes, you are. Hi, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Storytime with me, Mr. G, where I'm going to be reading the stories and you're going to come along for the adventures. Now, as you can tell, I've got a special guest with me today. His name is Spud, but he also goes by Spuddy Buddy and Spudderuffagus. And I'm saying Spud like the potato, S-P-U-D. And I brought Spud along today because today's book is about a boy growing into a man and his dog. But this book has a twist. It's got a pretty big twist on it. Something that I think is going to be really interesting to talk about after the video. And today's book is called I Always Wanted One, written and illustrated by Olivier Tallec. And I think you're really going to enjoy it. So if you have the book, go ahead and grab it and you can read along with, or you can read the subtitles, or you can listen to my voice and I will take you on this adventure like I always do. But either way, me, Spud, and all of you are gonna get going, so let's move out. I always wanted one. So that morning when I saw him there, I could not believe my eyes. I got a little bit closer and my heart beat a little bit faster. I could see right away how cute he was with his big, beautiful eyes, but he was so shy at first. We had to get to know each other. It's often like that with new friends. In the beginning, I wanted him to sleep in my house. We tried, but it was impossible. He refused to sleep and he took up all the room. We decided he should sleep in the cat's house. It's very big and is right next to mine. That way, he's not far away. I tried to teach him how to eat on the floor like everybody else, but he prefers the table. He's a really fussy eater. He doesn't like anything. I just think it's weird that he doesn't like dry food. He was terrible at washing himself too. But once he's dried off, he's all soft and warm. And lucky for him, I love brushing his hair. So it wasn't always easy. But then we found this game we love. He throws a stick and I get it and give it back. Then he throws it again and again. We could play for hours. Well, he loves it, but I have to say, it gets quite boring after a while. He doesn't behave himself all the time. He keeps on running away. I can spend the whole day looking for him. He always comes back eventually. Still, I wonder, where does he go all day? It's the same when we go on vacation. I'm always scared I'll lose him, but it's never for long. At home, the couch is my spot. I really don't like it when he climbs up to join me. But sometimes when we're watching the TV together and eating chips, he falls asleep. And that's quite cute. And I must walk him every day, even when it's raining. If he stays in all day, he tends to get frustrated. But I like to show him off. All my friends have one too, but I think mine is the best one. I know he was a gift, which is great, but I sometimes wish I could have picked him myself. There are just so many of them to choose from. It's fine though, he's still cool. And anyway, I think we quite like each other. We've known each other for a long time now, years even. He's grown bigger and takes up all the room on my couch. He still doesn't like dry food, and he still loves that stick game. But we remain the best of friends in the world. Whoa, was that a cool adventure or what? Did you guys catch that twist? It was subtle, but then all of a sudden it dawns on you, or at least it dawned on me. Well, the twist was, if you didn't catch it, that the story wasn't about a boy talking about his dog. It was about a dog talking about his boy. Yeah. crazy, right? It was all from the dog's perspective. I read a couple books like that, and they're always so interesting. You know, I always think about, what is Spud thinking about? What would Spud say right now if he could talk? Do you ever wonder what your dog or cat or horse or cow or lizard or whatever animal you have, do you ever wonder what they would say if they could say something to you and how they're perceiving the world? It's interesting, isn't it? Like in the book, it was perceived that, yeah, playing fetch with a ball is fun, but I'm mostly doing it because you enjoy throwing the ball so much. And I'm like, oh my gosh, is that what Spud thinks? Am I just boring him? Because I think he's having the best time. But maybe he thinks that I'm having the best time, which I am having a really good time, to be honest. And do you ever think about what your dog's voice is? How does your dog sound? Like, is he British? Is your dog German? Is your dog have a Spanish accent? I don't know. Is he walking around with a New York accent even though he's never been from New York? Or is he walking around with a British accent even though he's never been to Britain or England? Or does he sound Southern? I have no idea what Spud would sound like, but I always wondered, and I always wonder what he would say to me. Anyways, that's enough about how Spud would sound or how our dogs would sound, but it is interesting to think about. Now, this book is being, the story, I should say, is being released during the National Adopt a Dog Week. And I think adopting a dog is a really great way to get a dog because there's so many dogs out there that need homes. Spuddy Buddy was adopted and he has been the best good boy. He's tired because we went on a long, long walk, hike thing just now. But he is the best good boy and he's always so happy and in such great spirits. Aren't you, buddy? I promise he is most of the time. Anyways, if you're thinking about getting a dog, adoption is always a great way to go. And if you're not in a position to do that, then that's okay. Or if you're getting a dog a different way, then that's okay too. But adoption is always an awesome route. Now, if you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button, the subscribe button, and the bell. That way you'll be notified when Mr. G comes out with new stories. And if you want this book, then go down to the description and you can click on a link and you'll be able to buy it. Yeah, and it'll also help me out, which is pretty cool. And I just want you to remember, as always, that you are fabulous and I love that about you. It's one of my favorite things about you. It really is. And I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. And I hope that you are feeling fabulous and have joy in your heart. Peace out. I'll catch you next time with Mr. G. Come on, sweaty buddy. Come on. We're all done. We can go outside now.
This is first time in more than a couple inches of snow. Sweaty buddy, what's going on? You like the snow? Yeah.